I'm Addie Clark, an applications engineer here with MTS, and today we are going to be going over a simple tensile test. A tensile test subjects a sample to a tensile force until failure. These tests are to acquire data such as ultimate tensile strength, yield stress, and Young's modulus. The sample can be any material, such as plastic, steel, or woven fabric, just to name a few. These samples are cut to size, measured, and placed in the testing machine. The testing machine has several parts. For this test, we will be using four main pieces of equipment: a load frame, a load cell, grips, and an extensometer. A load frame houses the motor that will be creating the load that is transmitted to the specimen by moving the crosshead up on the support beams. Today we will be using an MTS Criterion C43504 load frame. This frame is capable of transmitting up to 50 kilonewtons. Attached to the frame is the load cell. This is the device that is used to measure the force transmitted to the specimen. Today we will be using an MTS 10 kilonewton load cell. Grips are attached to the load cell and the base of the frame. Today we will be using MTS Advantage wedge grips. These are a mechanical wedge grip. They are easy to use and do not require any additional equipment, such as pumps. After the specimen is placed in the grip, an extensometer will be attached. An extensometer is a device that is used to measure the elongation of the sample. Now, you may be thinking, why can't the load frame be used to measure elongation? And while you're right, the crosshead will measure elongation, it will not be as accurate. There are too many other pieces of equipment between the crosshead and the bottom of the load frame to provide a reliable result for the elongation of only the specimen. Therefore, an extensometer placed directly on the specimen is highly recommended and often required by some standards. It is also worth noting that all of this equipment can be calibrated to their respective ASTM and ISO standards. The specimen is placed in the testing area. The Advantage wedge grips help ensure proper alignment and help minimize the preload on the specimen. Now that the test is set up, we have to set up the software. Today we will be using MTS Test Suite. We will be using the pre-made template EM Tension Simplified. Each of these boxes represents a command. As we work our way down the procedure, the command gets more and more complex using parallel paths for things like break detection and data acquisition. This test will begin once we click the green play button. The crosshead will begin to move, and data collection will begin. After the test is complete, we can remove the specimen and the extensometer from the test space and return the load frame to its zero position. Now you know the basics of tensile testing. Thanks for watching.